Hello and welcome to FEEDZY RSS Feed Lite. In this video, I will show you how to get started with this plugin and how to display feeds into your blog posts, pages, and on your sidebar as well. Ready? Let's get started. First, you have to log in to your WordPress dashboard and then click on Add New under Plugins. Here, search for FEEDZY and install the FEEDZY RSS Feed Lite plugin. Once the installation occurs, make sure you activate it and then move to the next step. FEEDZY allows you to group all your feeds into a category and then fetch them at once. To create a new category, go to Feed Categories under FEEDZY RSS and click on Add New. From there, you can put all your feeds URLs in the category feeds text area, separated by commas, like so. Name your category and then click on Publish. You can now copy the slug and use it as a parameter. More about that in the next step, so keep watching. To do that, click on Add New under Posts and then click on this FEEDZY Lite button above the editor. Remember the parameter mentioned earlier? You can use that parameter here, instead of the full URL, if you want to display elements from all those feeds together. If not, just type in the single URL of the feed you want to use. You can use more than one URL as well. Just make sure you separate them with a comma. Before moving to the next step, I encourage you to check if the feed works. You can do that with a web-based tool provided by W3C. Link in the description. You will get the confirmation if the feed is valid right after clicking the check button. Once you are sure everything works well, you can go back to the dashboard and continue with the fields and settings below. Choose how many items you want to display. Let's say we want to see 7 items in this post. Yes or no for the RSS title, and then how long you want the plugin to cache the feed results. Next, select the sorting order of the date and title, and then move down to the item options. Here, you can set the behavior of the links on click from automatic to blank, self, parent, top, or even frame name. If you choose blank, for example, the link will open in a new tab, like so, and self will open the link in the same tab, and so on. In this field, you can trim the title of the feed to show only 50 characters, for example. Then, you can choose if you want to display the date of publication, the author name, and abstract description of the retrieved item. I will leave both options as they are by default. We'll see how it looks immediately, so keep watching. Crop the description if you want it to 140 characters or less. This can be helpful if you have more than 5 items on the same page. What we need to do next is to move to the item image options, because these fields here are active only for premium users. More on those functionalities in a future video, so make sure you subscribe to our channel. Here, you can set the image display as auto, yes or no. I choose yes, and I will set a default image as well. You can do that either by using the URL of the image or simply by selecting it from the gallery. Finally, you need to set the thumbnail dimension in pixels, using numbers only, and then you can click on Insert shortcode below. Now, it's time to see how it looks live. To do that, click on Preview here. It looks awesome, right? Not really. What if you don't like what you see? Don't worry, you can change the look of the feed right through its shortcode. Here's what you need to do. Let's say you want the default image to be horizontally aligned to the text, okay? To do that, you need to make the image smaller. Change this value in the shortcode from 150 to 100, then save the changes. If you preview the post now, you can see that the image looks much better near the text. Furthermore, if you want to get rid of the publishing date or other details, and you want to have clear elements, which will display only the title and summary, change these parameters in the shortcode. Publish the changes and you are done. To do that, go to Appearance, then click on Widgets. Here, click, hold, and drag the FEEDZY RSS feed widget into the sidebar area. Open the widget and start by filling up the fields below. Widget title, intro text, and then type in the feed source here. Set the number of items to display, 7 in this case, and then choose for how long you want the feed results to be cached. Set the sorting order in the drop-down below and then move down to the item options. Here, I recommend choosing the following options. Blank to open the link in a new tab. Trim the title of the item after 50 characters. Set No for both date, author, and description. You can keep the same settings as you do in the posts, but remember that the sidebar area is much smaller, so it can be helpful to set these values to match the size of your sidebar. Now, if you want to display a custom image near each element of the feed, you need to copy the link of that image and paste it in this field. To do that, go to Media and click on Library. Click the image you want to use and copy its URL like so. Make sure the entire link is copied, so click here and then type Ctrl plus A on your keyboard to select the entire content. Now right-click and copy that link to your clipboard. Go back to Widgets and paste the link in the default thumbnail URL field, like so. Now, if we set the image size to 100 pixels here, it will look like this. It is too big for sure, so I will lower the value to 30 pixels. Let's see how it looks after we save the changes. Better, right? What if we trim the title to 25 characters? Let's do it and see how it looks. This is how a FEEDZY RSS feed widget should look like on your sidebar. Sure, you can display the date of publication, author name, and description if you want it, but I think it will be too much for this small area on your website. I think we are done. Is there anything I missed about FEEDZY and you want me to show you? Do you have questions about this WordPress plugin? Leave your comments below and I will do my best to answer it. See you in the next video.